लाइन स्टडी ऑन क्रिमिनल प्रोसीजर कोड. इन दिस क्लास विल डिस्कस द प्रोविजंस इन चैप्टर 11 ऑफ द कोड दैट इज प्रिवेंटिव एक्शन ऑफ द पुलिस. यू नो that police is there to prevent the offense, prevent the commission of offense. When an offense is committed, investigation is done by police. So this chapter 11 of the CRPC, what it provides, the preventive action of the police. Everybody knows that police comes into picture when an offense is committed. But here in this chapter, a duty is cast on the police to prevent the commission of a cognizable offense, not non-cognizable offense. So section 149 provides police to prevent cognizable offenses. Police is not asked to prevent non-cognizable offenses under the criminal procedure code. Only prevent the commission of a cognizable offense. What it says? Every police officer may interpose for the purpose of preventing and shall, to the best of his ability, to the best of his ability. What is, how far he is able? If a single police officer is there, a group of persons are there, they are going to commit a criminal offense. It is the best of ability. So every police officer may interpose, what for the purpose of preventing, and shall, to the best of his ability, prevent the commission of any cognizable offense. You are aware, what is a cognizable offense? Cognizable offense means an offense or a case is a case which is shown as cognizable. In the chapter, in the schedule of the CRPC, there it has been provided which offense is cognizable. So what it says, every police officer may interpose. Interpose means what? Interfere. May make him try for the purpose of preventing, and shall, to the best of his ability, shall to the best of his ability prevent the commission of any cognizable offense. So what is cognizable offense? You are aware that a cognizable offense is an offense which is shown as cognizable offense. Or what is cognizable offense? That is, what is cognizable offense? That has been defined, a arrest when a police officer may arrest without warrant. Bailable and non-bailable offense, those are two definitions. But here, cognizable, that is, what is the offense is cognizable, that has also been mentioned in the schedule of this code. Cognizable offense, what it says, the cognizable offense means a case in which a police officer may arrest without warrant And that is not only that, that whether that offense is cognizable or not, that has also been mentioned in the schedule of the CRPC. What is cognizable means? An offense which a cognizable case means a case in which a police officer may, in accordance with the first schedule, that is first schedule, it has been mentioned whether it is cognizable or any other law, for the timing in force, arrest without warrant. Why I am saying it is first schedule, it has been shown as cognizable, it is also shown as cognizable offense according to the first schedule. So according to the first schedule means, if it has been shown as cognizable, then only that that is to be, a police officer may arrest without warrant. So here section 149 says, probable officer, every police officer shall interpose to prevent and shall, to the best of his ability, but prevent the commission of any cognizable offence. 150, information of design to commit cognizable offence. Suppose a police officer gets information that some person is planning to commit a cognizable offence. So in such case, section 150 of the CRPC provides that he should immediately give information to his superior officer or any other officer whose duty is to prevent the commission of such cognizable offence. One section 150, every police officer receiving information of a design to commit any cognizable offence, every police officer, your irrespective of the officer in charge, sub inspector, nothing, every police officer receiving information of a design to commit any cognizable offence shall communicate such information to the police officer to whom he is subordinate. Here police officer doesn't mean only sub inspector of police or inspector of police or the superior police, any police officer, even a constable. If a police constable will be treated as police officer, so as per section 149 also, a police constable is also required to interpose or prevent the commission of a cognizable offence and shall, best of his ability, what will prevent the commission of a cognizable offence. Section 150 also provides, whenever a police officer from rank of this constable up to the SP, any police officer who receives any information what of a design to commit any cognizable offence, the plan that somebody will commit a cognizable offence, shall communicate such information to the police officer to whom he is subordinate and to any other officer whose duty it is to prevent or take cognizance of the commission of any offence. Whom he will report? He will report to the such, what type of report? If he receives any information, any police officer receives any information that of a design to commit a cognizable offence, there is a plan for commission of a cognizable offence, shall communicate such information. Whatever information he has got, that information he will communicate to the police officer. Police officer, that such information I have got, to whom he is subordinate, and to any other officer whose duty it is to prevent or take cognizance of the commission of any such offence. Here cognizance doesn't mean, that is, cognizance taking legal notice. Cognizance, the word means taking legal notice of it. So here, to prevent or take cognizance of the commission of any such offence. 151, arrest to prevent the commission of cognizable offence. Suppose a police officer, who are knowing of a design, if a police officer knows a design or plan to commit any cognizable offence, even that police officer may arrest that person if arrest is required to prevent for commission of the offence. Section 151, a police officer knowing of a design to commit any cognizable offence may arrest. If a police officer simply knowing, this is another power which is given to the police officer, not in the officer in charge of police, to arrest a person when he knows a design to commit such offence, such information to police officer to whom is commission of an offence, and without order, he can arrest also without order of the magistrate.
the person so designing, if it appears to such, if a person so designing to commit cognitive offense, if it appears to such police officer, if it appears to that police officer, that the commission of the offense cannot be otherwise prevented. That person is arrested, the commission of that cognitive offense cannot be prevented. This section 151. A police officer may also warrant a person without warrant of the magistrate, without order of the magistrate, where he knows a design to commit a cognitive offense and it appears to him that unless that person is arrested, unless the persons who are designed to commit that cognitive offense are arrested, the commission of that offense cannot be taken. No person arrested under subsection 1 shall be detained in custody for a period exceeding 24 hours from the time of his arrest. If that is the constitutional direction also, in the CRPGs of the provision is there, once a person is arrested, he cannot be detained beyond 24 hours unless his further detention is required or authorized under any of the provision. If the magistrate authorizes, then he may be detained. Further detention is required or authorized or any or under any other provision of this court, or the criminal procedure law, or any other law for the time being in custody. This is section 152 provides prevention of injury to public property. Suppose a police officer is even a constable, he is not some inspector of police. So even a police officer like that comes from the rank of constable up to the higher rank police officers. This section 152 provides what? When a police officer can interpose to prevent any injury attempted to be committed in his view to any public property. When a police officer finds somebody is causing an injury to any public property, whether it is movable or immovable, or the removal of any, or he is causing injury to any public landmark, or by that is 16C, by or other mark used for navigation. So what section 152 says? A police officer may of his own authority, he has been authorized, may interpose to prevent any injury attempted to be committed, any injury which is attempted to be committed in his view, to any public property. Now, in his own authority, may interpose, but to prevent the attempted injury to any public property, whether movable or immovable, or the removal or injury of any public landmark, public officer, police officer may interpose. That is, interpose, preventing any injury or removal of any injury to any public landmark. You know, landmark is there. Suppose somewhere it has been a pole or some that is a survey pole, etc. Landmark or by or other mark used for navigation. 153. Inspection of weight and measures. So legal metrology act, that is a department, metrology department is a separate department. That the metrology officers are there to examine the weights and measures, but here section 153 also gives power, an additional power to the police officer, that any officer in charge of a police station, only police officer in charge of the police station, not other police officer, any officer in charge of police station may, without a warrant, enter any place within the limits of such station, within his police station limit, but for any place, for the purpose of inspecting or searching for any weight or measure or instrument, for weighing, used or kept therein, whenever he has reason to believe, if the officer in charge of the police station has reason to believe that somebody is using a false weight, false instrument for measurement or for weighing, then in such case, whenever he has reason to believe that there are in such place any weights, measures, or instrument, weight measures or instrument for weights which are thoughts. Who can interrupt that? Only the officer in charge of the police station. He can interrupt when he has a reason to believe that somebody is in possession that he is of any false weight or false instrument of measure. He can interrupt at any place to find out whether that is a false one. If he finds in some place any weight, measure or instrument for weighing which are false, if he finds any false weights, measures or instrument for weighing are false, he found from the possession of somebody, he may seize the same and shall forthwith give information of such seizure to a magistrate having jurisdiction. This is section 100. There are four sections we discussed, that is section 149 to 153. That is, these are the preventive measures of the police, preventive actions of the police. First, to prevent the commission of a cognizable offense, or to prevent the injury to any public property, or to officer in charge has been authorized to inspect and to find whether if any person is inspect any place to find out if any false instrument of measure, weight and measure is there. So this is preventive action of the police. This chapter 12 is very, very important chapter. What it says? Information to the police and their power to investigate. Everybody knows that a case is registered only by police whenever information of a cognizable offense is given to the police. So when a report discloses a cognizable offense, then only police will register it. Section 154 of the code provides information in cognizable cases. When information is given for commission of a cognizable offense, the police is bound to register. No preliminary inquiry is required. What is it? Lalita Kumar case is the leading case. Still, it is ruling the subjects. This is in force. What it says in Lalita Kumar case, the Supreme Court has held that whenever any report which discloses the commission of a cognizable offense, the police is bound to register the case. Police has no option to refute or to make any preliminary inquiry to find out what the allegations are to before registering the case. What it says? Every information relating to the commission of a cognizable offense, every information, it is whether it is oral information, it also includes oral information. Every information may be given in writing, or information may be given through phone. So every information relating to the commission of a cognizable offense, if given orally to an officer in charge of justice, Every information, if orally, but for regarding the commission of a cognizable offense, if given orally, to whom? To an officer in charge of a police station, shall be reduced to writing by him. Who is an officer in charge of the police station? Yeah, it has been also defined. Officer in charge who has been declared as, who has been appointed as officer in charge of the police station. If in his absence, any other officer below his rank, but above the rank of the police, will be treated as officer in charge of police station in his absence or in that police station. So, what every information he gave orally to the officer in charge of police station shall be reduced to writing by him. That officer in charge must shall reduce that information into writing by him. Or under his direction, if his personal is not able to, or if not, instead of reducing that information by him personally, he may get it reduced into writing by any other officer. But he called another resurrection. And many readers were putting once any information, every information regarding commission of a commercial offense, if even orally, that shall be reduced into writing by the officer in charge of the police station or by the authorities directs of the area of police station, police officer, and be read over to be informed. And a piece of information, whether given in writing or reduced to writing, given information given in writing or whether reduced to writing, shall be signed by the person giving it. So once that is reduced to writing or an information, that must be signed by the informant. If a written report is given, you got a permission to pay commission of offense by anybody, that must be signed by that person. And the substance there, substance reason, that is the brief, what is the substance? Substance is, that is the summary, but the substance of such information shall be entered in a book to be kept by such officer in such form. And the state government may prescribe in this. The state government has made a book, substance of such information shall be, that be kept, must be kept by such officer in such form, in the such form, sometimes you say station diary, etc., such form, at the state government may prescribe in this law. As you are aware, section 154, very important. But it provides every information to the police regarding commission of a cognizable offense, if given orally to the officer in charge of the police station. If somebody is not the officer in charge of the police station, then you should not be able to report. If it is given orally to the officer in charge of the police station, then that shall be reduced into writing by that officer in charge of the police station. Or as per his direction by any police officer. And that shall be read over to such person. If every information is reduced into writing, or if it is given in writing, then that must be of the signature of the person who has given that information. And a copy of such information, copy of this, should be given to the informant on the request. And the substance of such information, subject of such information, shall be entered in a book to be kept by such officer. Such officer means the police officer will maintain a book, will keep a book as in such form as prescribed by the state government, and in that the substance of such information must be mentioned. Provided that if the information is given by the woman, by the woman against an offense under section 326A, that is the sheet attack, and 354, that is outrage and modesty of the woman, 354A, 354B, 354C, 354D, 376, that is offenses against women. Then, a section 37, section 509 of the Indian Penal Code is alleged to have been communicated or attempted, then such information shall be recorded by a woman police officer or any woman officer. What is provided? Provided if the information regarding commission of a cognizable offense against woman, that is given by a woman, the woman against whom such offenses are committed. What are those offenses? That is outrage and modesty of the woman, rape, this is she that attack, or it is 509, insulting the dignity of women, then that is, it is given by a woman, that shall be recorded by a woman police officer or any woman officer. Woman officer, not a police, because a woman police officer is not that. Any other woman officer of, in holding any office or the law, will be treated as woman officer. Provided further that In event that the persons against whom an offence under section 354, 354A, 354B, 354C, what are those offences? To go through the schedule 354A, 354B, 354C. Is that? That is. That is assault or use of criminal force to with intent to disrobe her. A woman with intent to disrobe her. That is 354A. 354, this is 354A. 354A, here not assault, that is sexual harassment of the nature of unwelcome physical contact and advance or a demand or request for sexual favors, showing pornography or sexual harassment of the nature of making sexually colored remarks. 354B, assault or use of criminal force to woman with intent to disrobe. 357, voyeurism. 354D, stalking. 354E, that is liability of persons who fail to prevent the commission of offence under section 354, 354A, 354B, 354C, 354D. These are, so this, in such case, in the event that the person against whom an offence under section 354A to 354D, section 376, 376A, 376B, these are offences of rape, or section 509 of the Indian Penal Code, is alleged to have been committed or attempted, is temporarily or permanently mentally or physically disabled person. If the woman against whom such offence is committed, is either a permanent or temporarily a physical disabled woman, then such information shall be recorded by a police officer at the residence of the person seeking to report such offence. So at the residence of the such woman who is physically or mentally disabled person, mentally or physically, either temporarily or permanently disabled person, then such report is to be recorded at the residence of such woman seeking to give such report, or at convenient place of such person's choice, at the convenient place of such woman's choice. Then again, in the presence of an interpreter or a special educator, as the case may be. Why interpreter? Because if a mentally disabled person, unable to speak, etc., then in the presence of an interpreter or a special educator who can interpret whatever is she is saying, in such, you know, his presence, such report will be reduced. Such report is to be reduced into writing by such police officer. And second, the recording of such information shall be videographed. That means, whenever a physically or mentally disabled woman, whether permanently disabled or temporarily disabled woman, gives report, intends to give report regarding commission of an offence of rape, commission of offence of what is the outraging her modesty, etc., stalking, voyeurism, etc., then that is to be made, that recording is to be made by the police officer at her residence or at a convenient place according to her choice. Second, that the recording of such information shall be videographed. That is not, it is a mandatory, that should be videographed. The police officer shall get the statement of the person recorded by a judicial magistrate under clause A of section 3A of section 164 as soon as possible. Our requirement is that the statement of such victim woman who is physically or mentally disabled, either permanently or temporarily, when she gives report regarding commission of a sexual offence against her or outraging modesty of her, then that as soon as possible, or statement is to be recorded by a judicial magistrate as per section 164(3)(a) of the CIPC. Then a copy of the information as recorded under subsection 1. What is under subsection 1? Under subsection 1 shall be given forthwith free of cost to the informant. In every case, whatever report that is a fair packet report, that will be copy of that affair, copy of the report which is reduced into writing, that must be given on free of cost to the informant. Any person aggrieved by a refusal on the part of an officer in charge of police station to record the information referred to in subsection 1. Suppose any person who is aggrieved due to who is aggrieved, how? By a refusal of the officer in charge of the police station, either to reduce the oral report of that person which disclosed a complete offensive variety, or to resist to the police, or the report of the written report, and to reduce and keep the substance of this in a book kept in his copies. Any person who is aggrieved by such refusal of the officer in charge of the police station to reduce the oral report which discloses a compensable offensive variety, or to receive a written report which discloses a compensable offensive variety, then may say the substance of such information, a summary of such information in writing and by post to the superintendent of the concerned police station of the district, who is satisfied that such information discloses the commission of a cognizable offence. If that superintendent of police is satisfied that the report, only satisfaction, but that the report discloses a commission of a cognizable offence, shall either investigate the case itself or direct an investigation to be made by a police officer summoned to him. Then he shall either investigate that personally or shall direct that the investigation be made by any police officer summoned to him in the manner provided by this court. And such officer shall have all the powers of an officer in charge of police station in relation to that offense. When the superintendent of police directs that any other subordinate police officer will investigate the case, then such police officer will exercise all the powers of the officer in charge of police station in relation to that offense. Probably now you are clear what is section 134. Section 134 issue must be thoroughly, that means fundamentally. What it says? It is a very, now, after amendment, that is what it offense against a victim is a woman. If a woman gives information to the police demanding commission of a suicide attack, outraging modesty, or offense of committing rape, that is definitely, that shall be recorded, information shall be recorded by a woman police officer or a woman officer. If that victim is physically or mentally disabled, either temporarily or permanently, and intends to give such report, then in such case, such report is to be taken and the police officer at the residence of the recorded, such police officer shall record such report at the residence of that victim woman, and in presence of an interpreter or a special educator, as the case may be, if it is possible, then the recording of such report must be videographed. Hard requirement is that the statement of such victim is to be recorded as soon as possible by the judicial magistrate as per section 164, 3 of this year, 3A of this year. Then copy of the affair is to be given. Any person who is aggrieved by the refusal of the police officer to record the information reported in subsection 1, either to credibility of her delay of affair of the case was satisfactorily explained, then the same will not be, it was held to be credible. That is, manner of affair, affair recorded in continuous manner without leaving any possibility of insertion, etc. That is, registration of affair, many cases are there. That is, when a second affair, what will happen? Suppose any inquiry under section 174 of the code was conveyed initially in order to ascertain whether the death is natural or not. That is, after that, appellant claims that the earlier information regarding unnatural death MOPA under section 150. In the case was closed, the inquiry which was conducted for the purpose of ascertaining whether the death is natural or unnatural cannot be categorized under information related to the commission of a criminal offence within the meaning of the section 150. So, can it registration of a second error? It is well settled principle of that there can be no second error. First error is there at the event of any further investigation being received by the investigation agent in respect of offence or the same occurrence, or if a second error is received, then the available with the investigation agency in the said situation is to conduct further investigation formally with the leave of the court. That is the second affair. Second affair, there can be second affair. The first affair is also not clear. Sometimes these other events happen, there can be also second affair. So it is well said the principle of law that there can be no second affair in the event of any further information being received by the investigating agency in respect of offence or the same occurrence, or including giving rise to one or more offences for the charge sheet has already been filed. If for the second time, if there is some new facts are there, there can be further investigation taking permission from the court. Now, section 155, information as to cognizable cases and investigation of such cases. This section 155. When information is given to an officer in charge of a police station of the commission within the limits of such station of a non-cognizable offence, information as to non-cognizable cases and investigation of such cases. Section 154 says information as cognizable cases. But section 155, information as to non-cognizable cases and investigation of such cases. When information is given to officer in charge of police station of the commission of which within the limits of such station of a non-cognizable offence, he shall enter or cause to be entered the substance of the information in a book to be kept by such officer in such form as the state government may prescribe in this paper and report the informant to the magistrate. If the question comes, when the officer in charge of the police station receives information regarding commission of a non-cognizable offence within his local limits, then what you do? The police officer in such case, he shall enter or cause to be entered the substance of such information in a book to be kept in that police station as prescribed by the, in the forms as prescribed by the state government. No police officer shall investigate a non-cognizable offence, non-cognizable case, without the order of a magistrate having power to try such case or commit the case for trial. Asking the police officer, no police officer can investigate a non-cognizable case without the order of the magistrate who is competent to try such case or commit such case. Any police officer receiving such order, when order is issued by his magistrate, is competent to try that case or to commit that case, directing a police officer to investigate a non-cognizable case, then in such case, any police officer receiving such order may exercise the same power in respect of the investigation, except the power to arrest without warrant, as an officer in charge of the police station may exercise in a cognizable case. When the police officer receives order from the magistrate who is competent to try that case or to commit the case, to investigate a non-compliant case, then in such case, such police officer can exercise all the powers given to him with the officers and the police station to investigate that case, except the power of arresting that person, the accused, without warrant. Where a case relates to two or more offences of which at least one is cognizable, the case shall be deemed to be cognizable. Suppose the case relates to two or more offences, and one of the offences is cognizable offence, then in such case, that will be, it shall be deemed to be cognizable. In such case, at least one is cognizable, the case shall be deemed to be cognizable case, not to state that the other offences are non-cognizable. So once one cognizable offence is there, if other offences are non-cognizable, also that will be treated as a cognizable case, notwithstanding the fact that the other offences are non-cognizable. Now, 156, police officer's power to investigate cognizable case. Any officer in charge of a police station may, without order of a magistrate, investigate any non-cognizable case which a court having jurisdiction over the local area within the limits of the session would have power to inquire into or try under the provision of Chapter 13. So, if any police officer has a power to investigate any cognizable case, if it has been committed, which is the cognizable case which can be tried within the jurisdiction of the local police station. If it has been committed within the jurisdiction of local police station, and that case can be tried by the court under which local jurisdiction that police station is. No proceeding of a police officer in any such case shall any state be called in question on the ground that the case was one which such officer was not empowered under the section to investigate. Once the police officer, police station, has commenced the investigation, no proceeding of the police officer in any such case, once he starts investigation in the cognizable case, shall at any stage be called in proceed on the ground that the case was one which such officer was not empowered under the section to investigate. That can be question. 156(3) provides, any magistrate empowered under section 190 may order such an investigation as above mentioned. But as above mentioned, the police officer, any officer in charge of the police station, may, without the order of a magistrate, investigate any cognizable case which a court having jurisdiction over the local area within the limits of such station would have power to inquire. So, subsection 3 provides, any magistrate who is empowered to take cognizance of the offence may order such an investigation as the government of may order that the police officer in charge of the police station may investigate the case. Let us conclude. In the next class, we will discuss the remaining.